Live shot of Yonge and Dundas Square in downtown Toronto. Happy Monday, everybody. Welcome back to Breakfast Television. As the weather starts to get warmer, it's time to get back into making healthy, hearty salads. You can maximize the cold weather harvest that's still around, like kale, cabbage, root vegetables, and the like. Joining us now to motivate you to get back into the salad game is chef and food journalist Joanna Tymkiw. Joanna, good morning. How are you doing?
I'm so good. How are you?
Very good. I need all the help I can get in this category, Joanna, as you might know. So I appreciate you stopping by. Before we get started, your top three tips to make the best salad. What are they?
Okay. They are, do not dress your overdress your leafy greens, right? You want to do it a little bit at a time, work it in, toss it, then a little bit more until you're satisfied. Secondly, when you're working with cold weather leafy greens like kale and cabbage, massage it in. And yes, this is why I am wearing this glove.
Okay, no scary reason. I was going to ask. That's great.
You massage it in so that you really just don't get that cabbage or kale flavor. It all really incorporates. And then third, we're going to see that here today with all of these, is that we want to have a combination of complementary textures and flavors just to really bring everything to life. So yeah, that's what we're going to do.
All right, so you have, let's get going here. You brought us two recipes today that are completely plant-based, and they also include cheese and sour cream, and I am a sucker for some sour cream. So the first one is Moroccan-inspired slaw. Walk us through that one.
Yes. So what I'm doing is I am thinly slicing my green cabbage. As I said, cold weather, hearty, we're getting that in there. And then I have a vegan sour cream, yes, very, very good. Vegan sour cream, vegan mayonnaise dressing with a ton of cooling herbs like mint, dill, basil, cilantro. And what I do is I get it in there and I just massage it in. And a little bit at a time, as we said before, just massage it in, incorporate it, break it down. Do this with any cold weather, hearty green like this. And then once we have that in there, then we start adding our complementary textures and flavors. So what we do, the glove comes off.
Oh,
what
I was
we
a fan
do
of the
is
glove.
We add, I mean, it's soaking right now with dressing.
All right.
But what
Fair
we
enough.
Do is we add some salty feta. So this is plant-based feta. It's vegan. It's from Farm Boy. Just like this. Looks just like regular feta. Look, still even in that. And they have a whole line of plant-based cheeses. It tastes just like regular feta, as I said. And then we're gonna add some chewy chopped up dates, some crisp radishes, once again, another root vegetable right in there. And then also for some spice and a little bit of chew, we have some harissa roasted sweet potatoes. So harissa is a North African spice. It is made up of like cayenne, cumin, coriander, garlic. I mean, I don't know if you can see it in here.
Yeah,
it's red. It's beautiful. So then we have this beautiful slaw that's like full, as we said before, of like chew and crunch and saltiness and everything else. And then I just put a little bit more of my plant-based feta on top and a little bit more of my cooling herbs, which is also going to counteract like the spicy harissa. And so that is our Moroccan-inspired slaw.
All right, so
the next one.
Yeah, please, take the lead. Continue, Joanna.
I'm just
don't let me stop you.
The next one is our kale and orange panzanella salad. So this one is using kale, obviously. And what I did is I already massaged my dressing, which is like a tangy avocado dressing into my
Sounds
kale
good.
Here. And now I'm going to be adding like complementary flavors again. So I'm going to use some bright capers. And then I'm also going to add some orange segments. So I just add those in there. Orange, you know, this is just using some warm weather flavors that we get from Florida right down south, right? And we just get those in there with torn bread. So a regular panzanella salad uses like soaked bread. I like a torn grilled bread. And what it does is that when we get it in here with our dressing and let it sit for like a minute, what it does is it makes it a little bit chewy, but not like soaked, like a regular panzanella salad. And then on top of there, I'm using my vegan Parmesan shreds, once again from Farm Boy. And they're opening actually up, if you want to pick them up, they're opening up a new store, Queens Quay, Richmond Hill, in the next coming weeks. And then we have this salad that is like this mixture of beautiful bright oranges, a little bit of chewy bread, and capers in the Parmesan shreds. And then
fantastic.
What I do is I also top it off with a little bit of avocado. And then we just have this really rich, robust salad that you can top with like couscous if you want to use it, want to add some protein to it, or like roasted chickpeas. And what I also like to do is just like put it on a piece of bread with a little bit of avocado and just eat it like that.
Oh, done. Fantastic. Joanna, that's fantastic. Where can we find the recipes online?
www.joannatymkiw.com.
Fantastic, Joanna. Appreciate it. Have a good morning.
Thank you so much. Bye.
Bye. Those salads look good. I should eat more of them. Coming up, Nicole, with the live eye and celebrations of Blue Mountain. It is an absolutely gorgeous start to the day at Blue Mountain. Nicole joins us right after this. Hey, Nicole, you're watching BT.